Biografi Life and Times of Ki Hajar Dewantara di Masjidai Takbar 11 IPS 1. The Development of Good Character Should Be the Heart and Soul of Education and Should Dominate the Spirit of Teaching. This was the philosophy of the father of education in Indonesia, Ki Hajar Dewantara. The reason he said was that teaching and character building are like two sides of a coin and cannot and should not be separate. Education, by definition, means guiding student lives in a strong foundation of good character, so that they would be civilized humans of highest moral fiber. Thus laying the foundation of a great nation without distinction of religion, ethnicity, customs, economic and social status. Ki Hajar Dewantara was born in the royal family of Yogyakarta on 2 May 1889. His given name was Raden Mas Suwardi Suryaningrat, which he later changed to renounce his connection with the royal family. He transformed himself into an activist, columnist, politician, and pioneer of education for Indonesian. He fought for the right of Indonesian during the Dutch and Japanese colonial eras. He was born into an aristocratic family that granted him the privilege of free access to education of his choice. He got his primary education from ALS Europisch Lager School. Then he continued his education at Stavia Java Medical School, but due to health reasons he couldn't finish it. He started writing for newspaper, and eventually all his writing were focused on Indonesian patriotism. Thus until that he was involved in the early activists of Budi Utomo and the Indonesian Party, which were both important in the early development of the Pergerakan, the movement that grew up with an ascent of Indonesian national political consciousness. He was exiled between 1913 and 1919. Following the publication of two of his articles, as ik eens Nederlander, if I were a Dutchman, and N for Allen and Allen for N, one for all and all for one, he used his time in exile to learn more about education and obtained a Europe's certificate. Following his return, he focused more on cultural and educational efforts, paving the way to develop educational concept in Indonesia. He believed that education is very important and the most important means of freeing Indonesian from the clutch of colonization. He played a leading role in establishing National Ordowic Institute Taman Siswa in 1922. This institution was established to educate native Indonesian during colonial times. This institution was based on this principle: 1. Ing Marsa Sung Tulada, the one in front set example; 2. Ing Madya Mangun Karsa, the one in the middle bulls, the spirit and encouragement; 3. Tutwun Handayani, the one at the back give support. As Ki Hajar believed that character was not merely a theoretical concept, but a practical and living concept, he embodied in his vision in his school, Taman Siswa. The central goals of Taman Siswa emphasize character building, including traces of patriotism and love for the nation, and a sense of national identity. His vision was that Indonesians would be free from colonial powers to fight for independence and have good character. He continued writing, but his writing took a turn from politics to education. This writing later laid the foundation of Indonesian education. Froebel Montessori and the Tagore influenced his educational principle, and in Taman Siswa he drew some inspiration from Tagore Shantiniketan. After independence, he was given the office of Minister of Education and Culture. For his effort in pioneering education for the mass, he was officially declared Father of Indonesian Education, and his birthday is celebrated as the National Education Day. His portrait was on the 20,000 rupiah not till 2002. He was officially confirmed as a national hero of Indonesia by the two presidents of Indonesia on 28 November 1959. Iki Hadjar Dewantara passed away on the 26 April 1952. At the age of 69 years, his wife donated all Ki Hajar belongings to Dewantara Kirti Griya Museum, Yogyakarta. He was a great man who spent his whole life serving his people and country. Thank you.